And I got to go ahead and say, kid show, man, Globetrotters, I know we've had them a couple times, but this one, they're revamping everything. They're, like, adding in the new athletes. They're, like, breaking new world records. And they're trying to get an NBA team. That's what's really cool about this.
How's that going to be fair?
Exactly. But they're petitioning right now. They're trying to get signatures. They're trying to be the, was it Las Vegas Globetrotters? I think it's Las Vegas. So that's cool.
Well, actually, anywhere that there's a...
But I think they want Las Vegas.
Expansion team.
Yeah, because but it would make sense for Las Vegas.
Yeah.
I just don't see how that's
Let's
fair.
Let's do the Louisville Globetrotters. Let's make this happen.
So is LeBron going to go up to this guy and he's just going to balance it on his head and do some crazy stuff cross him up?
The way the world has changed, why not?
Yeah.
They have actually lost some games, right?
Technically, they've never only lost one time, haven't they?
They've lost.
Haven't they lost one time?
I'm not going now.
I thought they lost one time to...
We've lost the flair.
Well, I thought they lost once. I could be wrong.
I don't know. The little commercial you shared, they were like 15,000 to zero against the Generals.
I thought the Generals beat them. Maybe the Generals didn't. They've been 95 years, people. 95 years of quality entertainment.
I know they've come close.
Okay, yeah. this is actually from HarlemGlobetrotters.com.
Yeah.
In fact, the Globetrotters have lost 345 games.
Really?
Over the course of 9 decades. However, with 27,000 wins, the Globetrotters do own the best winning percentage in the history of professional sports.
Well, yeah, I mean.
Whoa.
But think about the old days with the Meadowlark Lemons and the Curly Neals, and I mean that was fun. And you knew about this stuff from Scooby Doo and watching all those guest appearances and all that. I mean that was fun. Globetrotters are still fun.
Yeah,
they're entertaining.
And that's the marketing guy.
I'm just saying.
But it is the truth. I've seen the Harlem Globetrotters probably like 3 times that I can remember in my life.
Great show.
And I'm still going to go this time. I'll go every single time because it's different every single time you see the show.
Oh, yeah.
You're never seeing the same thing.
And the experience is by far the best with the kids. They will interact with the kids. Yeah. They will give the kids something that they will take home and cherish forever. The experience with the kids alone, man, you can't miss that.
Yeah,
I mean,
the last time that I went and seen the Globetrotters up there with y'all, like they had this little side pocket for the kids that they could play basketball.
Yeah,
like I thought that was such a cool thing.
Yeah, do a little magic pass, dribble, pass it around to the athletes. I mean, why not? They're eating it up. They're loving it because they're interacting with actual athletes. And these guys are great with the kids. I mean, it's so awesome.
It's a fun show.
It is.
I wonder how much practice goes into what they do. It's
too much, I feel like.
It is crazy. They probably don't have a life. Like, that's what they do.
It seems like, I mean, I think there's a lot because I know working with Globetrotters on this date, there were talks of that early on because I think they actually got back together December of 2020 and started doing the rehearsing and practicing and all that stuff, gearing up for at some point being able to tour in 2021.
Let's just say they practiced so much, Allen Iverson would not play. Talking about practice.
Are we going to talk about practice? Y'all really going to ask me about practice?
See, that's he wouldn't play. There's so much practice that. There.
No. So much practice.
So much practice.
But yeah, anybody that hasn't seen the Harlem Globetrotters, man, that is an incredible show.
Yes. Now, you know, I've seen Globetrotters probably a dozen times in 30 years. My son told me, he's be 20 in August, goes, I've never seen the Globetrotters live.
My wife was the same way.
Wow.
Yeah, and me and her are going to be going to this show that y'all got coming up. She's not a big sports fan, but I'm like, you have to go.
Yeah, you
like,
got to see.
Even if you're not a sports fan, I'm not a big sports fan either. Yeah. Really, like some sports, but I still have an incredible time just watching those guys.
Did you not let your son see the Globetrotters?
I guess. Yeah. Yeah.
Wow.
I apologize.
Leave him at the house. Y'all go have a good time.
Jeez. Yeah. Dang, Paul.
They have to be coming up on 100 years, though, right?
They're 95 right now.
95.
Yep.
Dang. I didn't know it was that close.
I'm telling you.
5 more years. That's going to be crazy. 100 years of the Globetrotters.
That's a milestone. Like, that's just crazy.
And we'll probably book it again.
Good. 100 years of magic.
100 years of magic.
Hey, that'll be a good one. I can't believe they've won 27,000 games.
When you're that good, you're that good. You know what I mean?
Imagine being one of the guys, though, to be able to say, like, you beat the Harlem Globetrotters at basketball.
Yeah, well, evidently 300-some can.
Yeah.
Surprising.
Yeah.